Welcome to the next quick unboxing on my channel, this time the Airfix Junkers U-87B1 Stuka, a very famous aircraft of the Second World War, which was used to quite some success by the Germans. It's a dive bomber. Stuka stands for Sturzkampfbomber, which is German for dive bomber. And I have to say that the box art is quite nice, with the Hurricanes and 109s dogfighting in the background. Other than that, the box isn't very special. Here we can see the two possible liveries, which we can also see here. And if you know my channel, you know that I mostly build modern fighter jets, but I read a lot of books about the Second World War, and one of those was the biography of Hans Ulrich Rudel, which was probably the most successful Stuka bomber in the Second World War. And his story was really fascinating, so I had to get one of these. And my plan is to make this my second entry to the Airfix group build that's now on Facebook in the group build group. My first entry to the group build is this Messerschmitt 262 that I'm still working on. If you want to see the final outcome of this, subscribe and check my other channels. But now let's go on with the unboxing of the Stuka. So again, the box isn't really special. So let's move on to the rest. In the box we get the decals. As I said, there are two different versions. And again, the print quality is really good. You also get an instrument panel. But again, same with the Messerschmitt 262, there are no swastikas. But I'm sure most of you have these in your spare box. But other than that, they look really good. I like the little piggies here. And yeah, that's the decals. Let's move on to the manual. Again, we get a bit of history about the Stuka in different languages. As I said, it was a dive bomber and it was quite successful at the beginning of the war. But it's a quite slow plane, and once it encountered the Spitfires and Hurricanes above the Channel and Great Britain, it had to suffer quite a bit. And by the end of the war, it was also used as a tank hunter, equipped with two 37mm cannons. But again, I don't want to talk too much about the airplane. It's all about this kit, right? So here we get the basic instructions and the icons. And then you start building. It seems like there is some kind of frame around the canopy area. And you also have the option of mounting a seat with seat belts, or use a flat seat with the pilot figure, which is nice. It also tells you something about an aircraft stand that isn't included in the kit. Anyways, you mount the cockpit area. It seems like there are also detailed side panels, which is awesome. Here, don't forget about the decal for the instrument panel. But what I can already show you is one of the extras that I bought, which is this instrument panel here. I got this from the aftermarket, and as you can see, it's quite detailed and it was also very cheap, so this should make the canopy look even better. Anyways, let's move on here. So you mount the cockpit and instrument panel, the side panels, and it looks like this frame here is to hold the wings in place later on. Here you mount the muzzles for the machine guns. The early Stukas were equipped with two 7.92mm machine guns. So you mount the wings. You also have to drill a few holes here if you want to mount the bombs, but that shouldn't be a big problem. The stabilizers and rudders. This seems to be the engine compartment. The engine itself isn't modeled, but that's okay. Then you move on with the wheels. And like it was the case with the 262, you also get these flat tires. So if you want to simulate the weight that's on the airplane, you get these flat wheels, but you can also mount them like that, so it's not visible. That's awesome. Again, I haven't seen that on any other kits out of the box, so this is a nice touch. Alright, so you mount the wheels, then these are the brakes for diving, and here the flaps. It seems like you can also display them in the upper position, which I might do. I got an idea to display the Stuka in a dive, but that would be quite difficult, I assume. But we will see. You also get what seems like four smaller bombs, probably 50 kilograms, and a larger one for the fuselage. And some smaller bits and pieces, and here the instrument panel for the rear gunner. This will be quite a challenge to mask the clear parts, but for that I also got myself some pre-cut masks, which will make life a lot easier. So you finish the cockpits, you can also leave it open or close it, mount the propeller, and that's it. And you get two options for the paint job. First one is Sturzkampfgeschwader 51 or Dive Bomber Squadron 51, stationed in France in August 1940. This is the version that I want to build. It's not that special, it has this splinter camouflage with a dark green and a grayish green. Hard to describe these German colors, but you get the RLM numbers also here, which is great. And the other option would be Kampfgruppe 88 Legion Condor from Spain in 1938 from the Spanish Civil War, which is also quite interesting, but as I said, the other option is what I prefer. So that's the manual, and now let's take a look on the parts. Alright, so here we have all the parts. It seems like there are a lot more parts than on the Messerschmitt 262. And this already looks quite nice, but let's start with the clear parts. I will leave them in there so I don't scratch them. But as you can see, you get the option to close the canopy or this three part option to open it. I think this one is where the machine gun goes through. And I really recommend to get one of those pre-cut masks for an aircraft like this. If you want to cut all these parts yourself, have fun, but I won't do that. Alright, let's move on to the parts. Here we get the propeller and basically the housing for the engine, I guess. So that's quite nice. And now let's have a look on those wings, they look really good. Panel lines are very crisp, not too deep. And you already get a feel for the size of the Stuka. And here we have these flattened wheels. There seems to be a bit of flash on the smaller parts, but that's not really a problem. And here the underside of the wings, also very nice panel lines. Here the housings for the wheels. I think this is a drop tank, and here we have the larger bombs and smaller bombs, the seat with and without seat belts, and the 50 kilogram bombs. And this seems to be the cockpit area of the gunner in the back. And a lot of smaller parts here, of which I don't know what they are. And last but not least, this sprue with the fuselage halves. I really like those panel lines. And here we have the pilot and gunner figures. If you consider that most manufacturers don't include figures at all, these are really good. And I think these are the diving brakes. Quite some detail here in this interior section. And these are the flaps. These are the instrument panels for the sides. This is also really detailed. So it seems like this will be quite an enjoyable build. I'm really looking forward to it. If you want to see the outcome, subscribe. And also check out my other channels on Instagram and Facebook. So thanks for watching, and bye.